Brokerages have begun cutting the Sensex targets. This morning we had Ambit reduce its target from 33 to 27,000, and Macquarie also has reduced its Sensex targets. Now the reasons for reducing the Sensex targets are quite a few. One is that earnings have not caught up. In the last 1 year, there was a lot of expectations that there's a new government in place and it will start showing into the corporate results and they will be much better. But for the last few quarters, corporate results have been anything but good. What's happening is that nothing's improved so far on the ground. So foreign institutional investors have now begun realizing, and I think it's their patience is slowly getting worn out. So that's the reason why some of them have now reduced the Sensex targets lower. Apart from this, of course, you have the China devaluation problem, and that's pretty serious. Because one thing is, it can indirectly affect a lot of companies. Though we have only about 10% exports to China, we import a lot. So the trade is quite high with China, and you know the devaluation will affect us. Though the exports are not so high, only 10%, there are very indirect ways in which it can affect us. For example, say a company like Infosys, it does business with a lot of US companies, and US companies do a lot of business with China. They have a lot of manufacturing plants in China. So if they are affected, the outsourcing will be affected for companies like Infosys. So what I'm trying to say here is there are a lot of indirect effects, if not direct effects. Of course, there are companies that are directly exposed to China, like Tata Motors has its JLR plant and derives about 20% of its revenues from China. So there are a direct as well as indirect impact. And so the factors to keep in mind would now be the Chinese devaluation, the US interest rates that are coming up, probably the Fed meets on 16th and 17th of September, that's next month, and there's almost a 50-50% chance that interest rates would be hiked in that meeting. So that's not good news for India, because people will move money away from India into government securities in the US, and this could affect the stock market as well.